if in the end this works and Yahoo starts to surge in profits and really compete successfully with its rivals, then Marissa Mayer will be heralded as a genius who took a brave and bold move. You did things a different way. You used to get rid of the bottom 10% of the workforce for poor performance comparative to their colleagues. Would she have been better off targeting the underperformers and allowing the ones who were producing but enjoyed working from home to continue?
Look, she's not going to throw out great performers. She'll use judgment. She'll let some have flex time. Some come in, some not. But she's got a problem. She's not running a perfectly oiled machine right now. She took over a troubled, broken company. And she's trying to put Humpty Dumpty back together again. And she needs to get all hands on deck to work with her to come up with the best ideas. As Yahoo progresses, or as special people are in different jobs doing certain work, Piers, she'll let them do it. She's no dummy. She's not going to blow up good people to get them in the office, but she's got to get the majority of people on the team developing a new culture to win. They don't have a winning culture. It's been a losing company for a long time. It's had a number of CEOs. She's come in, courageously taking the job, and is making a bold move to move the company forward. And in a turnaround, this is a turnaround, remember that. She's got to take some actions that go against the grain. Here taking a retro move, which takes all kinds of guts for a young woman taking over the CEO's job here. So I commend her for the guts, and I hope it works, and I know she'll use good judgment and not take some genius in a Silicon Valley mountaintop who's coming up with the next great product and pitch him out because she has to have him in the office. She'll use good judgment.